Good morning to all. Today we are going to see working principle of subsonic wind tunnel. Okay, in this wind tunnel we have to use in two laboratories. One is aerodynamics laboratory, another one is propulsion laboratory. Okay, before going that, we have to know about what is wind tunnel, why we are using wind tunnel in our aeronautical engineering. Okay, first of all, what is wind tunnel? Wind tunnel is nothing but we can call it a research tool, or we are going to find the aerodynamics problems in aerospace industry or aeronautical industry or automobile industry. Okay, so in that wind tunnel we have to use to study about effect of air around the solid object. Okay, so here we are going to see one by one construction of wind tunnel. Okay, in our aeronautical engineering we have different types of wind tunnels. It starts from low speed wind tunnel or subsonic wind tunnel and supersonic wind tunnel and hypersonic wind tunnel. Today we have low speed wind tunnel. The Mach number is less than 1. We can calculate like a velocity 330 mile per hour. Okay, so the setup, we know that wind tunnel setup. First we are going to the first portion of wind tunnel is effusor, also we can called inlet. Okay, in that effusor we can have honeycomb structure with wire meshed. The main purpose of honeycomb structure is to maintain the uniform stream flow at the test section and also to avoid the foreign material inside the test section. Okay, next we have to discuss test section. The next portion of our subsonic wind tunnel, the test section. Okay, the before that we seen the effusor. The effusor area 900 mm × 900 mm, that is reduced to a test section 300 mm × 300 mm, because we have maintained the uniform flow at test section. Then only we can follow that contour designed from effusor to test section. Again, the test section to diffuser we can follow 300 mm × 300 mm to 900 mm × 900 mm cross section area we can decide to effusor. Okay. In the test section we have made up of glass fiber, because we are easy to see what happened inside the test section. And only the both side we have the glass fiber, and also we have here the angle setup. If we fix this object inside, we can fix the different angle for our experiment. Okay, so in the test section we have the cross section area 300 mm × 300 mm, and the length is 550 mm. Okay, in this test section, inside the test section we have two pitot static tubes. One is vertical and another one is horizontal. The main purpose of pitot tube is we have to determine the velocity of air. Okay, so it is see here. The inside the test section we have two pitot tube. One is very horizontal, another one is vertical. Okay, the main purpose of these two pitot tube, we have to find multi-bank manometer or the digital setup we have here. It is connected to that manometer setup and also connected to digitalized setup. Okay. The inside test section we have also flow visualization setup. Okay, because of we are able to see the flow separation over a solid object or any other object, we can easily find the flow over the surface. And also we have lamp setup on top on the test section. We can easily visible to the flow setup. Now we are going to see that now right on test section we can be able to see that object clearly. Okay, so in the test section we have bottom of the test section we have electric strain gauge load cell is there. In this load cell we have to find the
We can call the six component load cell. In this type of load cell, we have to use internal balancing, and we have to find the six forces. One is lift, drag, and side forces, and the roll, pitch, and the yawing moment. Everything we have to find using these load cells. Okay, it is fixed vertically in subsonic wind tunnel. Okay, next. These and all, these all the connections is connected to the control board. Then from the test section, next we go for diffuser. Diffuser, we have more length, because of we have to send out the uniform flow in the outlet section. Okay, in the outlet we have the diffuser. Okay, from the test section we have a diffuser. Diffuser is nothing but it is the main application is the blowing the air from atmospheric. It is coaxial type of fan driven by 10 HP AC motor controlled by the speed controller. Then, here we have the control setup. It is connected to the AC motor. We can set up here. Adjust the velocity and speed of the motor. It will then produce the air in the test section. In low speed wind tunnel, we have two setups. One is a multi-bank manometer, and another one is digital measuring setup. Okay. In this pressure multi-bank manometer, we have to find pressure distribution over the any kind of object. Okay, we have that tubes connected to test section in the object, and also here we have a digital setup. Also, we have this connected to the test section. We can take both readings from test section. One is manually, and another one is digital. Okay, in this digital, we have a lift force, drag force, side force, yawing force, pitching movement, rolling movement. These six forces is measured from that six component cells. Okay. The multi-bank manometer, we have a different number of tubes. Which is connected to to the object inside the test section. If you run the wind tunnel, we can able to see the water level variation in that manometer. We can take the reading from that manometer, we can plot the graph, we can easily find that pressure distribution over the any kind of object. Okay. In our low speed wind tunnel, the following object we have to test inside the test section. The one is unsymmetrical aerofoil, and another one is symmetrical aerofoil, then flat plate, then cylindrical surface. We have the cylindrical surface, rough surface and smooth surface. Two types of cylindrical surface is there. Then the inside the test section we have which type object is there, and the final one is cascade aerofoil. In this cascade aerofoil, we have to analyze the compressor blade, the flow variation. We can easily find in our using our wind tunnel. The final setup of the low speed wind tunnel is the smoke generator setup, which is connected to our test section. Here we have some setup. One is we have that paraffin liquid, it is used to generate the smoke, and the heater we have used here. Heater, if once heater is on, the paraffin liquid will generate the smoke. Here we have used that blower. The blower will send to the smoke inside the test section. The smoke generator setup, they are connected to the test section.